Hi guys, it's Crystal with Design Bundles, and today I'm going to show you guys how to create full wraps as well as getting the perfect size for your mugs right inside Sawgrass Creative Studio. So let's go ahead and get started. So when you come to Sawgrass Creative Studio, this is the first page you're going to come to. And if you scroll all the way down to where it says Custom Canvas, this is what we're going to be using today. Now, please note there is a few issues with using Custom Canvas. Number one, you can't save this at all. So you're not going to be able to save this project, you know, your design or even the Custom Canvas size. This is something you're going to have to create each time that you use it, but you're going to get precise measurements. So I truly love it for with mugs. I use this all the time with a lot of things from phone cases and so on. So the second thing that you want to note here is this units right here. If you want to do yours in millimeters, then definitely leave it. If not, right away, first off, you want to change it to inches. Because if you start typing in these numbers here and then go to change it, it's going to delete these and you're going to have to just start over. So change your units first. I've done that here. And then I'm going to go ahead and type in our measurements. Now I'm going to go ahead and show you guys really quickly how to properly measure your mugs for this custom canvas. To find your measurements, you're just going to take a tape measure like this, these retractable ones, or a sewing one. So you're just going to measure it here to find the height, and then to find the wrap around the width here, you're just simply going to take, I go above so I'm out of the way of the handle there, and you're going to go all the way around the mug. Now you want to leave a little bit of a gap away from each side of the handle, and that's it. All right, so let's go ahead and plug in those numbers. I'm going to go ahead and put in 9 inches for the width, and then the height was 3.75. Now, normally when you use a canvas, you like to have the bleed line, so you'll want to put in at least 0.25 for your bleed line. But I have found with making these mugs, this is where I like to be. Now, if I do create any sort of little bit of a bleed line, I'll do 9.25 by 3.85. I don't do a lot on the height because then I find myself rolling the print or having to trim it down a little bit more. So I do recommend staying around 9.25 to 3.75 to 3.85. And now this is for 11-ounce mugs. So, and I think Cricut calls theirs 12-ounce mugs. So 11 to 12-ounce mugs. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and hit create. And here is our custom canvas. Now, what I love about this canvas is I know whatever is inside this space here, that's exactly what it's going to print. So whatever I throw in here, I can take it all the way to the edge, and it's going to be exactly 9 by 3.75. So what I want to do is point out another thing you need to pay attention to when using the custom canvas. So normally we use the measurements on this side and pay attention to when we're sizing things. So the entire time, if we bring in an image like so, I'm gonna bring in this one here. I don't wanna pay attention to the measurements on the side, whether I have them in millimeters or inches. These are not going to be correct. So you wanna completely ignore this. So that's another piece of using this. So ignore this, and this is only for custom canvas. I'm gonna go ahead and delete that. Now let's go ahead and do a full wrap. So if you were gonna do a full wrap, I've already brought in a few designs and I'm gonna have these linked below. So first off, let's bring in this pencil. So with this pencil wrap here, so this was a wrap that was created for either a sippy cup or maybe a 20-ounce tumbler, but you can still utilize those for your mugs. So let's say if I grab this corner here and I stretch it out, this is what can happen. So we can start to lose our pattern or our design. So what you can do is you can bring it up as high as you need to. You can come over to lock aspect ratio, unclick that, and then we can drag it to the right and left. So I'm going to go ahead and grab that square and we're going to drag it over just like so. Now I can then grab it here and move it around if I want to shift it just a little bit. I'm going to hit undo, and I actually need to bring this down just a little bit more. All right, so basically what we're doing is we want to make sure that inside of these dotted lines here, you're going to see another dotted line. This is just from our pattern. Inside these dotted lines is what matters. So this is going to be a full wrap. So I can either hit print, send it straight to the printer, and it's going to give me a straight wrap, just like so. Now, maybe you want to personalize it even further. You can definitely do that. Another thing to keep in mind is you can add multiple. So I can at least print 2 per 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And I'm going to show you that in just a second. So let's go ahead and send it to our printer. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick our printer. We're going to choose the paper. And I'm going to choose ceramic mug and Vivid. So I'm just going to choose my settings here and hit print. I'm going to hit OK. All right, so now that our print manager has popped up, you can see here's our design. It's ready to be printed out. But if you leave this setting here and go back to Creative Studio and create a second design, we can actually add another one to the sheet right here. So let's go ahead and head back. Back over here in Creative Studio, let's go ahead and add some things to this. What's really cool about these wraps is you can layer them up. So for example here, maybe I want to come over here and grab T for teacher. This is another design here, and I'm going to bring it in, and you can layer these right on top. Now you can bring in this grid line here, and this is going to help you center it up. So you can see this is going to be the exact center of our mug, and then you're going to know which one's right, which one's left. And then these are going to help you center it right between the left side and the right side. So really pay attention to these grid lines, and that way you can really get these precise where you want them. So if I'm happy with this, I would turn off my grid and we would have it just like so. Now we can add text if we want to. So we can come to text. I'm going to bring in an uploaded font I already have. I'm going to use this one right here. And I'm going to type out Miss Thomas. All right. So then I can bring that out and put it where I want it. Once again, I can bring in that grid so I can see that center line and see right where I'm lining this up. There we go. So once I'm happy with this, all we're simply going to do is hit print. Now, to get it on that same sheet of paper, just make sure you choose everything the exact same way you did the first time. So choose the same printer. And if you have one printer, then you know you're choosing the right one. I'm going to go ahead and choose US Letter. It's mirrored. We're going to choose ceramic mug. I've got the same paper, and I'm going to change it to Vivid. So all of these settings are the same. I'm going to hit print. I'm going to hit OK. So now you guys can see that it's popped them both on the same sheet of paper. So now they're going to print at the exact same time, and this is going to save us paper. Paper is money. So what we're going to do is you're going to see here that it's just pushed them right together. You may be fine with that. You can take your paper trimmer and trim that perfectly, but you may not be able to. Sometimes maybe you'll trim, you know, maybe there'll be a little bit of pink on that side or a little black. So the safest thing to do is come to layout. So scoot over here to layout, come to spacing, and at least give it a 1. And you're going to see now I've got that white line in between. That's perfect for our scissors and our paper trimmer. So that's it. So now we're just simply going to hit print and you're good to go. So I highly recommend that you guys check out the custom canvas here. Now you could come up to blank products and you can type in mug, and you're definitely going to get some mugs here. They have a ton to choose from 15 ounces, 11 ounces. There's a few different 11 ounce mugs, and you can play around with those as well. And then just print it out, measure your mug, and see if those line up. But if you're struggling there, because all mugs are different, you can definitely just use the custom canvas and you're good to go. Now, it's not just for doing the wraps. You know, I can also come in here, delete the wrap. It's also for sizing out our single images. So I know this is my mug top to bottom, whether I want it this big, or this big. I can visually see that here on the custom canvas. So I could come in here, create the front of my design, and then I could come back to my galleries and choose another image to put on the back. Now I wanted to point out this super cute one right here. This one is currently free. I'll also have it linked down below, and I think it's super adorable. So not necessarily that I'm going to, you know, wrap this, but I can design out several fronts. So I'm actually creating 3 mugs. So here's 1, here's 2. So I can actually scoot this over for my paper. So here's 1, here's 2, and then let's go ahead and get a 3rd one. So here's my 3rd one. I can size this down, send this over. Just make sure nothing is touching. Everything looks good. I would hit print. And now we're going to have those all go over on one sheet. And I would do the same thing I did before. I would come back, I'd create another set, and I will have 6 mugs on one sheet of paper. So I hope you guys found this helpful. If you did, please hit the like button down below and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one.